Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Christ Jesus. In this, Nanak has given the to June to specialize as produced specialist in Sikhism. So each specialist Satguru, there were six in all, each specialist Satguru performed certain duties. And the first Nanak introduced Sikhism, or what is God and all the concept of God and everything and what's happening. General introduction. Then he handed it over to Satguru Angad Dev Ji, who then trained the people for making them suitable Sikhs. So Satguru Angad Dev Ji trained the raw material, or he trained the natural man to submit to the will of our Father and not to seek the graces or the blessings of the manly person, any manly or any stone idol or anything, but to God, so that they all know that is the God who is feeding them, who has given birth, and they should appreciate what God has done to them, and they should serve Him only, not any man. So, in the village where he was, there was no rain for a year. So people were very much upset, you know, that hey, this man come into our village and no rain. And there was a man which we call Fakir or Tapa. He incited them, look, you have got this man into the village, and that's why there is no rain. So they asked Satguru Angad Dev Ji to leave the village so that rain, tapa, the man could bring the rain. So they left. They went 7 miles away so that they have no influence on his powers. So still there was no rain. Then of course the story goes that the people then killed Tapa by taking him from one field to the other. Satguru Amar Devi said that take him, and any person who take him into his field, he will get rain. That they let them believe in that one. So those people who believed in Tapa, that it is his powers who by which the rain comes, they took him from one to the other field before the sunset. So by doing so, they dragged him. But those who knew that it is our Father who gives all these blessings, they did not handle him. They did not worry. They just submit themselves to our Father's will. So afterward, when there was no rain and this thing happened, then they bring Satguru Angad Dev Ji back to the village and they ask for forgiveness. So by testing the man, the power of all other powers, then all became submissive to God. So all became God-orientated and not to man-orientated. So that was a good crop that he produced and which he handed over to the next Satguru, who then specialized in another field of killing the doubts in the minds of the people. So when people are of, when the people become twice born and they are sensible, then they then have temptation to go for money rather than for God. That is called doubting stage. So this trinity which I have produced and have been used many times is very useful. So this is the natural man. These tribal people go to their natural men. So they are once born. So those who were twice born, they believed in God and they did not bother about rain. But those who are once born, they became impatient. No rain. This man is to be blamed. So it's they who took the tapa from one field to the other to get rain. Why twice born people? They did not bother. So he then made the people orientated to God, these people. And then they become twice born. When they become twice born, they have doubting, you know, whether to go for money and have a following so that you can earn your own praises or to go for God and not to earn your own praises self, but to glorify our Father. So people, you know, they in the world, most of the people, when they become twice born, they would put on some funny robes or do something or the other to make a following of the blind people. Only the blind people follow. And those people who follow them, they are prostitutes because they have married the man and they can't be marrying God. God, you're our Father. So you have to be careful. So these people then were, after being God oriented, handed over to Satguru Angad Dev Ji. And this is the part played by Satguru Angad Dev Ji, which I will do it in my next video. So it's very important to know that a person, when he is born, male, female, brown, black, or any color, or any country when he is born, it is not he who took the birth, but our Father gave us the birth. Now I test people, you know, whether they are twice born or once born, by asking them that I was born in India and you are born in England and somebody in Brazil, somebody in Africa, who gave us the birth? Now when those people who are the once born, they will say, my mother gave me the birth. So those people, they only know the things of once born nature. But they see with their two eyes, but they don't perceive. You have to be capable of perceiving that things of God you do not see but perceive. So very few people will say that it is our Father God gave me the birth. And those people who say God gave the birth in a certain country, whether you are male or female, in God it doesn't matter. That is why Paul said in Jesus there are neither male nor female, nor Jew nor Gentile, because it is inside you and not this physical body. Count in Jesus or in Satguru Nanak Dev Ji. So when you find that they are twice born, then only they are capable of understanding gospel. And that to understand gospel, they must become a seeker. So ask, seek and knock. Ask is to kill your ego and to know that you are given birth in a certain family, not by your own choice, but by the choice of our Father. Then you are twice born. Then you become a seeker. So that is what Satguru Angad Dev Ji stressed, that it is our Father who brings you rain. Remember Christ Jesus, when he rebuked the storm, then it became quiet, the weather became quiet. Then his laborer said, hey, look, this man can even govern the wind. So, same, you know, the Israel, sometimes it's producing fruit. When these chosen people become unfaithful to God, unfaithful to Abraham, and also unfaithful to God, because God gave them the birth and made them sons of Abraham. So the same land become barren. Whenever they are faithful, the same land becomes lush green. The parable of prodigal son, Isaac is the prodigal son, and Ishmael is the elder one of Arab, and the father is Abraham. So these parables you understand when you are a seeker. If you do not seek, nobody will give you. They are not, they cannot be word of God, or the his word cannot be written down in ink on paper. So you have to make an effort. You have to be sensible and make use of your Christ. Christ is in your heart. If you get drunk with the old wine of the letters, you desire it, not the new. So those people who rely upon the books, that this man professor said so, that professor said so, and they write a paper in which they, what about he himself? He has no say in that one. He all rely upon his stake, his own references. That is why when they write an article, they put so many references. This man, that man, so their stakes or their sport is the references. But in God, our sport is our Father. That you can't quote like those people do. So if I write an article in spirit, then I will not be quoting anyone, but I will be driving all these things through logical reasoning. And these university professors, they are drunk in the old wine. They cannot understand because I have given no reference to anyone. So this meant, then they call him heretic. So, as the Samaritan woman at the well, somebody wrote about her, you know, a woman talking about icons. She put her icon right with the halo of gold around her, that means son, the apostle. But inside she wrote that she was this Samaritan woman who was a heretic. So that's why the people call me heretic too, because they cannot understand the language I speak. They speak book knowledge, book language. I speak spiritual. So you should make use of your Christ. Christ in you. Start thinking logically. Only then you become a seeker, and only then you can find the narrow gate that leads to the royal kingdom of God, where the true vine Christ Jesus is planted. Then you can start working in that vineyard to emulate yourself so that you get grafted to the true vine Christ Jesus, which is called marriage. So Christ Jesus at Last Supper, Eucharist, performed the grafting process, marriage. After training his laborer so well that a stranger would not know which one is the real one. That is why they hired the insider, Judas Iscariot. So at Eucharist, when he broke the bread, it was in the name of Jesus. Unless you eat the flesh of Jesus. That is why Jesus said, this is my body. And then he took the wine and said, this is the blood of Christ. Blood of Christ is his word. His word is the new wine. The bottle of new wine is with our Father. That is why you cannot pour the Eucharist wine from two bottles, but it is to be poured from one bottle, which is held by our Father, and that water does not have water in it. So these people put water because of the Old Testament is water, moral laws. The New Testament is spirit. So to justify the moral laws, they just put water into the wine. This is a corruption by the Jewish people. So they are baby sons of Satan, a baby princes of darkness. In India, we are kings and emperors of darkness. So what you meet in India will be much, much greater darkness. That's why Christ, Nanak, was the greatest of all the Christ. Sabde Vata, Satguru Nanak. Our Father God blesses you.